Hello everyone, Epiclipsy, and today I'm bringing you another video of Prospects Guide. So in this, I'm really going to try to show some tips and tricks about using the controller and basically controls and why I would really recommend it. Because I know I put a video out before with keyboard versus controller, and a lot of people ask me, do I use controller? And the answer to that is no, I do not use controller. I have been trying to switch, but I have a lot of hours on keyboard, so it's taking me a very long time to get up to the same skill level. So, first, with controller, a big advantage that keyboard doesn't have is this. With your right analog stick, well, I'm using Xbox controller, so, but it's the same with the PSN. Your right analog stick, you can look around. On keyboard, you can't do this. It doesn't work. So that's a big advantage. Say you're going and like you can look back and you can look to the sides and stuff. I know you can look back like this by holding the analog stick. Well, for me, it's holding the analog stick, but you really do get a lot more view of the playing field. Say you're looking at have ball cam on, you can look forward to see, you know, if a boost is there instead of having to like take off ball cam or something like that in ways. Or say you're not on ball cam and you can look over and see the ball. So that's a big advantage. Besides from that, I want to really go over the controls that I use. So I use a little different controls. Obviously frontwards, backwards, RTLT, the steering right, and the jump boost and stuff. But what I use is the same thing that really the pros use as well, is LB is for power slide, and then also LB is for air roll. So those are a big difference there. They used to come from B, or I believe it's O on PSN, but I switch it to LB. It's just a lot easier to use, and if you keep your two fingers on the back of your controller, it really helps out. And then also what I change is focus on ball is to LS, which is less sick, which really allows me, if I'm like driving around or something, to easily switch on and off to ball cam. So say like I want to grab a boost, make sure it's there, you can switch on and off without having to, like, I think before it was like RB or something, and it's just a lot easier and a lot more convenient. Next, what I did is on Xbox One, it's the two little square buttons. I switched that to scoreboard, so it's easier for me to pull it up in case I want to look. I don't know why, it's not really a big difference, but I personally like that. And I believe that should be it for all I did. Yeah, basically, that's all I did. And I think I moved reset shot to RB for training and stuff. Another thing that I really want to go over with you is, it's not really a big controller thing, but it's something that's kind of just in the whole terms of this. My camera settings. So my FOV is 102, my height is 110, my camera angle is -5, and my camera distance is 260, stiffness is 0, and swivel speed is 250. Now, this can vary, but I recommend definitely putting your FOV up, because this allows you to see more of the field and see more around you, so you can, basically, it helps with dribbling, because first of all, you'll be able to see if an enemy's coming. An enemy? Yeah, I guess so. Someone from the other team is coming. And it also allows you to see, basically, if a boost is there, and it just allows you to see more, so it's very helpful. Another big thing about controller is flying. Flying controller is a lot easier because you're using the analog stick to really control how you're flying, so you can slightly go to the right and stuff a lot easier, and especially when you're using air roll, it's a lot easier to fly because you have a lot more range of motion. Like with keyboard, if you're not very good at it, it could be kind of difficult because you only have the four different ways to go. I mean, it really makes, well, technically you have a couple more, that you have like eight ways to go, but it makes flying a lot harder. And the 16 directions on the ground for me can sometimes be a pain in the ass, but in the air, it really helps out because it gets me better angles on shots and you can cut in the ball better. But that's another big thing for controller. So overall, keyboard is not as good as controller, and even if you're better at keyboard now, I would give controller a shot. And if you really, really can't get the hang of it, then I wouldn't recommend switching, but I would give it at least like 50 hours of gameplay and really see how you are. Like, I'm already seeing the difference, seeing things that are a lot easier for me on controller, and I'm getting closer and closer to switching. But the last thing that I want to say in this video is basically, as many of you may have seen before, I came out with the Hidden Mutators, me and my friends. So what we're working on right now, little surprise, we may get it before it comes out, is basketball. I'm pretty sure we can play it and we'll be able to release it, but as soon as we get it, I will make a video on showing you guys how to do it, and I will release it to you guys. So this has been Epic Eclipse. I hope this has helped a little bit, and I will see you guys in the next one.